5th of June 2017. Probably one of the most strangest days I've ever witnessed during the 18 years I've lived in the Gulf. It was Monday, 10th of Ramadan, and I had my suhoor and went to sleep. Just a normal, regular day you would spend in the Gulf.
Saudi Arabia,
Bahrain,
United Arab Emirates
broke off diplomatic contacts
with Qatar.
Some people are calling this the biggest political crisis to hit the Middle East in years.
But I wake up and open Facebook as a routine, and I remember this very clearly. I saw a Facebook status from one of my friends, Joe. The status was, "Can any one of my Doha friends explain what the hell is going on right now?" And I go like, what the hell is going on in Qatar? This is not something your friends would ask you when you're living in Qatar. You know, it's one of the safest countries in the world. So I got curious and tried to find what the hell is going on. And it really didn't take that long to find out because it was all over the news. It was an unprecedented day in the history of Gulf, probably. Today marks 3 years since the blockade of Qatar. Honestly, in the beginning, everyone thought this would last a day or two, probably a week, a month maximum.
We would expect that over the next 2 days, the diplomatic efforts to try and resolve this crisis, this blockade on Qatar, will quieten down.
But here we are talking about it 3 years later. So I decided maybe I should share some thoughts and my opinions on this whole bizarre crisis that we witnessed here in Qatar. So after some reflection, I shortlisted 4 takeaways that I wanted to share with you. So the first takeaway is the power of art. Honestly, I never witnessed how art could play such an integral role in uniting people or rallying them behind a certain cause. If you ever read about the blockade of Qatar, it is impossible for you to miss this image. This image is one of the most fascinating things that I've ever witnessed in my life. When the blockade of Qatar happened, this image went viral, and you would see it everywhere. By everywhere, I mean everywhere. You would see it on skyscrapers. You would see it as your WhatsApp profile pictures. You would see it on cars. You would see it on people's shirts. You would see it on malls. And people started signing these posters everywhere, in malls, in public places. So I feel if anyone wants to understand how important art can be, they need to study about this image and how this piece of art allowed people of Qatar to weather the crisis that they were facing. So the second learning I had from this crisis was understanding about food security and understanding where our food comes from.
Milk, eggs, cheese, even chicken, almost all of it comes from Saudi Arabia.
But a blockade by Saudi Arabia and others in the region has cut off those supplies.
So basically, before the blockade of Qatar, I never really paid any attention to where the stuff that I eat or buy originates from. Qatar's food and medical supplies used to come from Saudi Arabia. We all got a shock. We weren't prepared. Nobody ever prepared for something like this. And I think we all started to make those conscious efforts of trying to buy local and trying to make an effort towards self-sustainability and achieving food security. So I think this is something we can all learn from. So my third learning was how important it is for countries to invest in their people. And since Qatar has one of the highest spending on education, health, and research, I realized I actually saw how beneficial this was for Qatar during the blockade and this whole crisis. Since the country has been investing in its people, when the country was facing a crisis, everyone stepped up and wanted to contribute in any way they could. And I think it was one of the main reasons how Qatar weathered this whole crisis. So my fourth and last takeaway is that truth always comes out in the end. So in the beginning of the crisis, there was a lot of misinformation and fake news about Qatar. Now, 3 years later, there's a global consensus that Qatar came out stronger from this crisis. And all that misinformation and fake news doesn't matter anymore. So here are the 4 points that I wanted to share with you. I really want to know where and how did you find out about the blockade of Qatar? And what have you learned from this whole situation?